mtu hapa ameongelea watu je kwa kuropa. Kila mtu tu unaona huko tu watu wa siasa wanajionea tu wanaandika watu wao. Sasa si sisi wengine hatuna connection. We don't have what to say. So I was asking how can we connect people from Nandi? I think Nivo tu. Thank you.
Sawa sawa. Milton, kuna watu wenye ungependa wakuje, hit KOT inbox. Alafu utapata directives. Or if you have information, you can also hit my inbox and then I'll refer to KOT.
Sawa sawa.
Yeah, asante. Amos, are you present? Amos, are you present? Amos?
Yes. Hello?
Okay. Amos, are you talking?
Yeah, Elsa, can you hear me?
Go ahead.
Thank you.
Amos was kicked out by internet. Kiumbani, go ahead.
Yes, good evening. Good afternoon, sorry.
Good afternoon.
So my name is... thank you so much. My name is Steven. I'm back here again. I was here in the morning. I'm a border rider from Mem. Thank you so much for this opportunity. Number one, we should... on civic education, we should continue educating our people, telling our people that on the 8th of August, we are coming out in large numbers to go and liberate this country. Also, regardless of the work you do, you should make sure that at least in a day, you tell about 20 or more people that on the 8th, we are moving out. Personally, as a border rider, I'm making sure that each and every customer that I carry, I pass this information as it should be. And I'm very happy because my customers are giving a very positive response. Number two, like personally, I'm right from printing a reflector jacket, written 99, we are all getting out. Because I'm very confident that on 8th, everybody will get out. I happen to listen to part of the committee that is doing the vetting because I'm somehow busy because of my work, but I'm reasoning when I'm not busy. Those guys are asking what I will term as useless questions. I was expecting the committee to ask very important question to Professor Kithure Kindiki, like the questions of up to now, when he was a CS for Interior, about 60 youth died. 60 is not just a number. 60 is not just something people are coming out with. Those are the number of young people who have died. I was expecting the panel to be asking him, when is he planning to appear in a court of law? Because he should, because he was an Interior CS. I was expecting them to ask him, when is the inspector of police, that guy who resigned from the police service, he should not just walk freely. I was expecting the panel to ask him, when is such guys appearing in the court of law? When? Because you cannot have 60 youth dying, and the guy is there happily answering questions. Number two, I had him say that his net worth as it is now, is 694 million. That guy in less than 2 years, that is about 20 months since he was sworn in, he has accumulated over 150 million. Sincerely, 150 million in less than 20 months, that basically means he's earning over 7.5 million per month. And he is not even a business person. He's not in business, he's just a civil servant, an employee of this nation. Bearing in mind the high taxes everybody in Kenya is paying, a person cannot be earning 7.5 million in a month after all the deductions, after all paying tax, after everything. 7.5 million leave in a month. That is money that should shock everybody. That is something that should make us, like, that should fuel us. Even those who are saying that they are not coming out on 8th, that should be something that should tell them they should be coming out on 8th in a very high number. Someone cannot be earning 7.5 million in a month, whereas we know his salary. We know that that guy doesn't have companies. He's not a business person. Even people in business are making losses at this moment. Everybody in this nation, I bet they are making losses. Because no business, there's no business that is kicking in a very high speed like that one. Someone cannot be earning that money. Number three, the last I want to say this on Kithure Kindiki. That guy had accumulated 544 million for about maybe 30 years. He's 52, so he was employed the first time as a CS when he was 50. So he had accumulated 544 million in 30 years. But in a range of 20 months, that guy has accumulated 150. This is pure theft. Pure theft. Those guys are taking our money without even mercy. And shockingly, that might not even be the truth. The truth might be he has taken over that 150 million. If you see a politician confidently standing before media and before a vetting committee and the media, that means he has accumulated more, only that he cannot tag the actual money. Lastly, I'll keep on insisting in this platform. Let us tell our people that on 8th, we are going to the streets, and not just going to the streets and coming back. We are not coming back until Baba Shireen resigns. Until that guy puts a pen on a paper and says that now me and my administration, from the president to the MPs to the governor, everybody is going home. We start Kenya afresh. And my fellow patriots, what I want to say is, after those guys have resigned on 8th, because I am very confident they will, very, very confident they will, after they have resigned and we take power, we shall put the good people in that power, and we shall make sure that those good people will also make sure that the guys that we have taken out of office, they must face full force of the law. They must go to the court, and they must be judged. And as I keep saying each and every day, corruption is existing. Anybody who is corrupt or who has any stains of corruption, I have insisted severally that they should be taken to the court of law. A judgment should be made. All their properties, the properties of their wives, the properties of their family members, they should be retrieved by EACC. And Rastria not stop saying this. This nation must be hanged to death. We cannot allow those guys to be walking scot-free, their families enjoying our money, them enjoying the root, but us as normal Kenyans, we are in a very bad state. I want to say that those guys must be hanged to death. Someone corrupt in this nation is an enemy of this nation. And as I wind up, as I said, I'm from Embu. I don't really see people from Embu here on X. I don't know why. I would wish that you kindly follow me, and I'll thank you all. Have a nice evening, and receive greetings from the people of Embu, mostly Boda Boda riders, the guys we work with. Thank you so much.
Asante sana Kiumbani. Wow. That English, according to community aspect of Boda Boda people, it doesn't belong to you.
thank you so much. We are civilized, we are educated, and I want to end that I don't know what to call it, of saying that Boda Boda guys are not educated, are not civilized. we are goons. No, we are not goons. We are good guys. We are fathers. We are brothers. We are your sisters. And we also wish the best for this nation. Actually, we want the best for this nation because even our work is affected. You know what we used to earn some 3, 4, 5 years ago and what we are earning now? We know the prices of unga and all those things we used to buy 5, 4 years ago, and we know the prices now. So we are in the first line to fight this government. This regime government must go out. We must fix this nation. And yeah, we are in the front line, guys. We are with you. And we said yesterday there was a memo that came out. We are against anybody trying to bribe us. And if anybody tries to bribe us, obviously we shall take that money and we shall come and expose them here and in other platforms. Because those guys bribing boda riders, they are our enemy number one. You cannot be taking money on your own, eating with your...
Did we lose Kiombani? Simon, maybe you would go ahead as Kiombani is checking on his internet.
With your girlfriend, with your wife.
So much for giving me this opportunity. Can you hear me clearly?
Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead, Simon.
So I appreciate for this opportunity. I'm quite excited because it is for the first time I'm on this space. So for me, I'm going to speak on some few things, especially to the fields that are mostly affected. One, the farmers. Secondly, the people in the construction. Let me educate you a bit. In the construction industry, when this government was coming into power, the prices of maybe cement was around 600 Kenya shillings, but right now, but currently it's around 800. The prices of steel, maybe a common steel that we use called D10, was around 800 Kenya shillings, but currently it's around 1400 Kenya shillings. You can see the margin, you can see the difference. So what does that tell you? So the other day you heard them saying that they are going to tax things that they will be importing. They are going to tax them. And that one included something that they could refer called clinker. Clinker is the major component used to in the manufacturing of cement. And they were saying that they had opened a company in West Pokot that they would be using to manufacture to produce that clinker. So my question was, so since that company, there is a guy called Devik, I know you all know him. He was on Citizen TV and he said himself that he owns the company that was manufacturing clinker on West Pokot. He said himself. So, and we know that that guy owns the company called Siba Cement, which one is one of the key players in the cement industry. So what happens is that currently we are suffering. And that guy is now manufacturing clinker, which will be used in the production of cement. What will happen to other companies? What will happen to other companies like Tebo, like Dovu Cement? What will happen to those companies? Yet for those companies, they depend on importation of clinker. What will happen to those companies? That's the same guy that said Ruto should rule this country for 25 good years. That's the same guy. That's the same guy who owns majority of steel production in this country. We know that. He has the Devik Steel in Athi River and another company here in Ruiru. So the first, even if you are heading and targeting our president, he is our enemy because one thing, he went to deal with that person, and we already know. And that person talked with whatever he talked with the government, and he gave them whatever he gave them. But now they have to, that deal has to come to an end, because he's controlling the industry right now. We cannot buy, the people are not constructing. I've been in the house for 2 good months. I've been a never at the size Jerry Parent, because I own a company in Inadina Construction. When you visit a client, the client wants you to go low on your budget, but you can't risk. Remember, I've employed a few people. Right now, they are jobless. I can't even pay them. Because of what? Because the industry is corrupted. Yet that same person is saying that the government is going to build cheaper houses, that the government is promising the youths. So many millions of youths are unemployed here outside. Wanataka wedo wakafanya mjengo. So you want to tell me, out of the class that we graduated back then in 2021, the class that we graduated, that the 50 people you are in the building, that you are doing building technology. So out of those, the only people who are employed, I know there are two. The rest to go kwinje. With the government promises, all those people wafanye kazi uko kwao. Yet that is one institution. That is not possible. So one thing we shall have to, on hashtag Nananane March, when we go to those offices, they have to go home, because we have to take back our country. You cannot tell me that in the difference of 2 years, the prices have skyrocketed that much. People are unable to construct. Watu hawezi kujenga. And na watu wakosa kujenga, wenye tuko na kampuni za kuchukua hizo contract, we cannot have jobs. Inabidi tukae tu. Why? So we need to ask ourselves, hawa watu wako mjengo, though that day, I'm reminding my friend that day, hakuna kukwenda kazi. Kauko na kazi mahali hakuna. It's the highest time to toke. Wacha tuende tuwabie, now it's enough. Whatever they are saying they want to construct cheaper houses, we don't care. People can construct houses for themselves if they have been given the right opportunity. But the government is inafinya kila kitu. There's no, when you overtax the steel, when you overtax the cement, you have finished everybody. Nobody can construct. These are the same guy, when the guy called Dagote was trying to bring his cement in Kenya. These are the same guy who made that. He's a good investor, we all know him. But they made deals and that guy was chased away. He went to open a company in order. So we lost an opportunity because they fear competition. So we have to, even if I'm mad by that, by Ruto, we all have to be mad because everybody is affected in his or her own way. So let me talk about the farmers, especially in a place called Kien. So by the guy that Walichoma supermarket, Zaki Anaitwa Achieni. So that guy, those farmers, let me tell you, they depend on petrol to farm. Let me talk about maybe something common like onions. So when that farmer is farming onion, 1 kg of seeds, it costs around 30,000 Kenya shillings, which you can farm around 3 acres of land, that K, which will require a lot of petrol for you to farm that. Remember back then, let me give you a rough way of when these people are coming to power. Back then, the petrol was a bit cheap. I can tell you, I can take you to people in Kieni who managed to buy plots by farming, managed to buy cars by farming, and they managed to take their kids to good schools, and they were farming, and they built good houses back then. But right now, nobody can be able to do that because of what? The prices that they were selling back then, it is the same, The prices that they were buying petrol has increased, seeding has increased, fertilizer, you can see where the government is bringing fake fertilizer. And then to make the matters worse, they are saying that we are competing, they will be taxing things that are coming from our neighboring countries, like Tanzania. Let me tell you, even if they overtax 20% of onions coming from Tanzania, I can tell you there are people in Kiwara, it is in Kenya. There was a time that person, the production cost of him, he is doing around 70 Kenya shillings, but ile kitungu inatoka Tanzania inafika hapo Kiwara, inafika hapo na 20 Kenya shillings. What will happen to that farmer? Even if the tax that you kitungu unaifike huku Kenya na around 40-50 Kenya shillings, the farmer in Kenya will still cry. Because that person amekomboa shamba si yake. Ananua fertilizer, he is doing everything ndo apate kitu kwa hiyo kitungu. But now, what will happen? What does the government do? The government is not ready to construct dams. You saw the other day, Ruto had opened a certain dam in somewhere in Meru. I can't remember the place. He had opened. Na akasema itajengwa. The only thing today, the only thing it is there, ni ile kitu ilifanyika hiyo siku. Haijajengwa. But I can tell you the man was, my pesa ilitolewa. I've seen in some parts in Rift Valley, same case is happening. He has opened a certain project 2 times and he's going to open it that time. Na bado pesa zinatolewa. This is the same guy who are told by Uhuru, kuhusu Arore and Kimborel, and I don't know how we ended up believing him. So on Tuesday, or not on Tuesday, but on hashtag Nanenane March, everybody should come out very angry. That day we are not going to negotiate with anyone. Because the moment we show them our teeth, we show them that we are smiling, they take us for granted. There's no way that person can fire all his cabinet alafu awarudishe. Anatubeba kawa jinga. He thinks, I don't know how he thinks, but that person, whoever advises him, is wrong. Because there's no way he can do that. And the members that were not returned, I heard that they are being nominated to be ambassadors in other countries. Like, what is he trying to tell us? What is he trying? Why are we doing that for nothing? So I heard even Kidiki saying that those who went into parliament were criminals. He has not yet been even made a cabinet. Let me say that I'm very mad currently because right now, yesterday, let me give an example. Yesterday, nilikuwa somewhere in Kikuyu kupimia client. And I did him.
Did we lose Simon?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Simon.
So, okay. So I was saying, the client. These are the only people who can check. Because you can see now the prices. I told him, I've a very big profit margin. Because I was looking for this model. But the client, I told him, look at the prices. Still, everything, including nails. Kila kitu imeongezwa, hakuna kitu haijaongezwa. So everybody who is planning to build, jua pia uko kwa shida. So it's the highest time water to get, and we know we are fighting for ourselves. Our fathers fought for independence, and they were in forest. They stayed in the forest for 7 good years. And they had no constitution. For us, we have the constitution, we have the right. let's go to those streets. Let's occupy those his offices now. Because, but
is it my internet that is breaking or is Simon internet?
Am I the one breaking? Like,
can anyone hear Simon without breaking?
Simon is breaking a little.
Okay, maybe Simon, you can check on your internet and then you come back. Rails, go ahead.
Okay, thank you, Esther. I hope I'm audible.
Very audible.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for this chance. I've been longing to converse with you people. I want to bring some reality on the table. As it stands, we are not as united as we were on the 25th. We have lost momentum, and the people who are pushing this are no longer pushing this. I want to be clear. You cannot push this under the waters that cannot mobilize enough people to do what we have to do to achieve what we want to achieve. What we can do, because we have already confirmed that we are being monitored here, mobilize people on the ground. Personally, I have mobilized a lot of people, and people are getting some sense on whatever it is that we are doing. We are doing a great thing that is going to change this country. Right now, the political class has united, and they have united against us. All this vetting that is going on in parliament is just sham. They all know that you have the job. The MPs have the instructions. And the worst part of it is that the opposition and the government side have merged. So there's nothing we can expect from those sittings. I wish they just stopped wasting those money and just give those people the offices. Let them start working until we come and do what we have to do. I can receive that people are already talking of what happens after it. We are not supposed to talk of anything other than nanenan. That should be the point, and we should not deviate from it under any circumstance. I want to thank KUT Sonko so much. Esther, thank you so much. Because from what I can see, people are already talking about other things other than whatever it is that we have in plan. People are already talking of other things. Why should we be talking of what happens after death? That is everything. That is what we should be talking about. That is what we need to stick to at the moment. Last time, TikTok was very powerful in making the 25th demonstrations a success. I'm not on TikTok, I won't lie. Those who are on TikTok in this platform, what are you guys doing? Are you guys spreading these posters from your own level? Have you talked to around two or three people and told them whatever it is that is going to happen on it? Do you know that there are people who don't know that there's something that is going to happen on 8th of August? Another thing, I've never got an opportunity to talk to give my insight on what we can do to make this Nanenanyo match a success. But in my opinion, there's something that has worked and we are not giving it a chance. The concerts are really a success. We should have held concerts in every city, every big city, every big town, Kisumu, Nakuru, Nairobi, Eldoret, on Sunday. If possible, let there be concerts. That will be the point at which we will be mobilizing everyone. After the concert, everyone should be on the vehicles coming to Nairobi. We need to make this thing a success, because the political class, they really
they literally look down upon us. They know that there's nothing we can do because, number one, they have been able to corrupt the mind of people on the basis of their tribes. What are we doing to make these people understand that this country will only succeed if and only if we do what we have to do without thinking of our tribes? We as the youth have a very big vision for this country, but this vision is just within us. What are we making? Are we telling other people? Okay, for instance, the Boda Boda people. I saw Bonny Khalwale. You can go to his Twitter handle and check what he was doing. He was lining up all the Boda Boda people and counting them in five and giving them $1,000. We are still being given handouts, and people were lining up for those little shit that they've stolen from us. What are we doing as the young people? Why are we losing momentum? Where do we think we are going? If the bigwigs are, I hate to talk about this, but I wonder why we are talking of division. Why are people calling for unity? Why are we even divided in the first place? Has this been that people had their own agendas all through and it was not about bringing change to this country? Why am I not seeing people tweeting as they were in the before? Okay, I understand that they could be threats and all that. But then people need to do more. We need to think of other things like this concert thing. I think we should really consider it. It will work. It has worked. Even in this situation where everything is being countered by the government, the concerts have not been countered yet. We need to make those things a success. If we can mobilize concerts this weekend, I'm not sure if it's possible to make it a success, but then we need to do something, my people. We really need to do something. So.